Hey guys, Jacitus here, hoping you're having a great day as usual. So I made a holy guide, which was a deep dive, which was like a 50 minutes video, and that's way too long for most people. So here's the quick version of it. 8.3 Holy Paladin Glimmer Light Build Guide. So, talents, first of all. Your Mythic Plus talents will go Crusader's Might, Unbreakable Spirit, Fist of Justice, or Blinding Light, both have value. This is if you need the short AoE interrupt because your group is low on interrupts. And this is if you need more stuns because your group is low on stuns. Then always Devotion Aura, always Holy Avenger, always Sanctified Wrath, always Divine Purpose for Mythic Plus. For raids, the only thing that changes, Rule of Law. This is your raid spec. Now, for Azerite traits, you want triple Glimmer for both Raid and Mythic Pluses, and you want Light's Decree to extend the duration of your wings for both Raid and Mythic Pluses. So these four are a lock-in for both Raid and Mythic Pluses. Then your last two for raiding should be Avenger's Might. Those are your last two for raiding. And then for Mythic Pluses, Indomitable Justice or Radiant Incandescence to give you more damage output for Mythic Pluses for your last two Azerite traits. Then Essences. For raiding, you want to go Vision Major. You want to go Conflict and Strife Minor. You want to go Formless Void Minor. And you want to go Unwavering Ward Minor. For Mythic Plus content for your Essences, you want to go Spirit of Preservation to be able to flash a light your tank with way stronger heals to keep them up. And you want to go Crucible of Flame for the damage output. That's it for Essences. Then for gear and stat priority. As far as stat priority goes, for raid healing, your best stat is Haste, closely followed by Mastery, then Crit and Versat. You can get them up pretty evenly. I'm pretty heavy on Crit, but that's because of the gear I have. But you want to go Haste, up to 30, 32% even, then Mastery, and then the other two for raid content. Then for Mythic Plus content, you want to go Crit, minimum of 30. I'm at the lower bar right now with my setup. Maximum of 40. So bring your Crit between 30 and 40. Then Haste, you want it to be at least 20, but to make it more comfortable, around 25. So for Mythic Plus, it goes Crit, then Haste. And as soon as you go over 25% haste, then versatility becomes better than haste. So you could say it's crit, then haste equal to versat, then mastery is your worst for mythic pluses. Then for professions, I recommend going engineering and alchemy. Engineering for the combat res that Paladin lacks in mythic pluses as a healer. And then this helmet is a really good like side bonus for having engineering. And then alchemy, mainly for this trinket in mythic pluses, it's absolutely amazing to buff your potion, give you versat and a socket, this potion I'm talking about. And then having 2-hour flasks is actually really nice from having alchemy. Then corruption. For raid content, you want to find as many Ineffable Truth pieces as you can and equip all of them. To my knowledge, there's not a cap on that. As many as you can. Because Holy Paladin is the best healer in the game during Holy Avenger plus Wings, and the weakest outside of it. So the more cooldowns you have, the stronger you are. So get all the Ineffable you can. Then, a pretty close second is Leech Corruption. So for raid corruptions, really good. Then having a Mastery proc or amount of Mastery corruption would be really good after these. But you want to go Ineffable, next Leech, next stats in raids. Then in Mythic Pluses, it's actually quite different. Because once you get comfortable in Mythic Pluses, you're going to want to use Corruption for damage, not for healing. So for my Holy Mythic Plus set, I'm using a Twilight Dev, and it usually accounts for about 30% of my damage throughout a whole dungeon, which is insane. It is the difference between me doing 25k overall damage in a Mythic Plus and like 35 to 40k, this Twilight Dev. It's amazing. So you're going to want to corrupt for offensive corruption in Mythic Pluses. And then stats are good as usual. Then UI recommendations. You're going to want to have the abilities you spam close to the center of your screen to be able to monitor them. You're going to want to have a couple weak auras around here with Consecrate and your cooldowns, Wings and Holy Avenger and all that good stuff. And then you're going to want to be able to select an enemy and then heal people without unselecting that enemy. So if he'd be in front of me, I'd hit Zeta Strike right now without unselecting him. And that would be good, right? And then you're going to want a way to track Glimmer on your UI and to track cooldowns such as Divine Protection or a shield wall on your tank or a shield block on your tank or like, regardless, right? You're going to want a way to see cooldowns. If I use Bop on myself here, by the way, I don't click it. It's going to show me Forbearance as well. So I know that I can't Lay on Hands myself or Bubble right now, right? So you're going to want a way to see that. So that's where the UI recommendation. As far as add-ons go, I recommend Voodoo with Elsmere's profile. It's absolutely amazing to play with Voodoo and Elsmere's profile. By the way, you can find Elsmere's profile on waggle.io, if you're wondering. Find some weak auras to show you the spells that you want to see. I have one for Holy Avenger, have one for Wings, and I have one to remind me to press Consecrate in Mythic Pluses. That's the weak auras I use. I have one to remind me to put Beacon. So having a weak aura to remind you to put Beacon alight just saves embarrassing moments. Like, all Holy Paladins have had an instance once in their lives where, oh, I didn't have Beacon for like 15 minutes, right? You just forget. So yeah, having a weak aura for that is a really good idea. And then as far as a priority system goes for a rotation, for Mythic Plus, you're going to want a Judgment into Holy Shock offensively. Then you're going to want to use your Crusader Strikes to get more Holy Shocks. And outside of that, you're going to want to Flash a Light your tank to keep them up. And then Light of Dawn when there's enough targets in front of it to warrant using Light of Dawn. It's kind of a failure in Mythic Pluses. In Raids, your priority actually goes, don't really use Judgment except when you have like nothing else to press and your whole group is full. Then you're going to want to Shock and Light of Dawn and then use Zeta Strike to bring both of these cooldowns back down. So you don't want to press Crusader Strike when Light of Dawn and Holy Shock are available. So basically, now I'd use Crusader Strike. But in Raids, in Mythic Plus, you can kind of ignore Light of Dawn depending on your group comp, depending on positioning, depending on like Judgment Call with the scenario in front of you. It's not a big deal to use Crusader Strike and Mythic Plus to get Holy Shock back, exceptionally when you're DPSing, right? Because your whole group's full. So Light of Dawn not getting a benefit from Crusader Strike is not a big deal in Mythic Pluses. In Raids, it kind of is. So you want to use Zeta Strike to get both of these back down. And that's kind of how the priority system goes. You want to keep Consecrate down in Mythic Pluses pretty much at all times. In Raids, not as important. Kind of depends on the fight. Kind of depends on how solid the healing is in your group and how much you can afford to do DPS. But in high-end Mythic Raiding, you need to be healing, not DPSing, right? So that's it pretty much for the short version of the Holy Guide. If you guys have questions or would like to hear me rant for much longer on this subject and go way more in depth, I have a very long version, like a deep dive guide on Holy Paladin 8.3, or feel free to leave questions in the comments below or come and ask them to me on stream. So enjoy. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. And as usual, if you enjoyed the content, please hit that subscribe button. It really does help a lot. And you can also catch me live on twitch.tv/justsidious.